Whether you're a believer or not, there's no denying John Edward has a connection with his audience. He's helped celebrities like Oprah and Kim Kardashian communicate with the dead. In fact, we've witnessed amazing scenes right here at Studio 10 in previous readings of our studio audience. Well, John is here again and our sold-out studio audience are waiting in anticipation. So, John, it's over to you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. If I talk to you, I need you to stand. If you're able to stand, and they're going to hand you a microphone or put a microphone in front of you, just wait for that so that we can actually hear this. And do I have your participation that you'll be honest about your family?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. I promise I'll be as discreet as I can if we're going to an area that's private. If I'm going to an area that's private, just say, John, I understand that. That'll be code for shut up. So in order to kick this off, I'm going to give you guys the opportunity just to get the energy flowing. If you have a question, raise your hand. I'm going to start there, and then we'll go around the room, and I'll try to get to as many questions as possible, as well as readings. And just on behalf, just thank you guys for being here. Thank you guys for having me. I love being here. So thank you very, very much.
We love you.
So throw your hands up, and we'll start. You can go first. Please stand.
When someone passes, do they have any control over what people do after they pass?
They don't have any control over it, but they can inspire us. So they could put things in our path to let us react to that might influence us in a certain way to make you go, that's interesting. Like, because that's happened 3 times before. So patterns get established. People will see things in a certain way. So they can influence that. They could bring people into our circle, but they can't force you to date them. They could bring somebody into your life from an opportunity, from a career standpoint, but they can't get you a job. Yep. So they could provide like openings for you to be aware of, but it's always up to our free will. Like, that's the important thing. Somebody passed from a vehicle accident, but I don't feel like they passed in the accident.
My partner passed in a vehicle accident many years ago. Yeah.
Okay. And was it like never regained consciousness?
Never regained.
Say it again.
Never regained consciousness. Yeah.
And did you guys have to make a decision regarding things after he passed or after the passing?
He was trapped in the vehicle and there was a lot of mystery around it, and his family shut me out of the funeral and had a little baby with him, and it's just a horrible time. So a lot of answers and questions.
So you were removed from that?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, are there 2 other kids or...?
I've got 3 more kids after that. Yeah.
So I'm supposed to talk about, like, more. Like, talk about more. And where's the George, or where's the...
I've got an Uncle George in spirit, yeah.
Okay, so George is here.
Yeah.
And connected to I have a hard time hearing V names, but there's a V sound. I'm hearing a V name.
I've lost 7 babies. One of them is going to be Vanessa.
Okay, because they tell me to talk about the V being there. Yeah. And then why is the month of April important?
My dad's birthday. My partner, the past, was in April.
Okay.
Our son was in April, so April was very significant.
So I feel like I'm supposed to bring up the month of April, but 2 separate signs, because April split up in 2 separate signs. Yeah. So someone has got to be more the Aries, and someone's got to be more the Taurus, correct?
Oh, absolutely. My partner was 14th, so that's Aries. Is that right? I've gone a blank. And 27th is my son, and he's, yeah.
Okay, so it's splitting it up that way. And then is somebody known for, like, I don't know what this is, raising birds or doing
something? Uncle George, yeah, had birds, was a farm man, yeah, birds, pigeons, all in our family, yeah.
And did somebody go through the process of having, like, a facial reconstruction, or did somebody have some type of surgery done on one side of their face?
My cousin Joanne had a brain tumor and her hair never grew back. She died at 27, and so one part of her hair was very, for 9 years, people would laugh at her in the street and, you know.
Okay. Yep. And that's a J name, you said?
Joanne, yep.
And is Joanne's dad still here?
He's in spirit too, my Uncle Bob.
Okay, so who's the older male that Joanne would know that's still living?
Probably her brothers.
Yep. Still here?
Yeah. Oh, what, his birthday's today. Yeah.
Because she's telling me to acknowledge the older male and her family still, like, make a big deal about, to me, which would be above you, which would be like father.
Yeah, he's about 2 years old, 4 years older than me, I think, yeah.
And then did you ever work in culinary, or did you ever work with food, or did somebody work in the food business?
Yes, I was apprentice pastry cook. No. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, thank God. Okay. All right, don't move. So is mom also passed for you?
Yeah.
And were you and she not on good speaking terms?
Oh, no, we were.
Okay, hold on. I want to be really clear.
Yeah.
They're showing me that 2 people were not on good speaking terms.
Yep.
before they passed?
My mum's sister, Joanne's mum, weren't speaking.
Okay, is Joanne still here?
Joanne's the brain tumour.
No, Joanne's mom's still here?
No, she's in spirit.
Then I'm supposed to tell you that they've been able to reconnect and make that okay, or make that better.
Yeah.
And are you... You're not adopted, right?
I have I found out as my mother was passing that my father wasn't my father. Yeah.
Oh. Because it's time to talk about somebody being raised by someone who's not their biological parent.
Yeah, my dad. Yeah.
Okay. But you were fine with that. From what I'm being shown, is like you were fine with that information.
I tried to contact the man after my parents died. He didn't want to know me, so my dad that raised me is my dad.
Yeah, because they're making me feel like you're fine with the information. I don't know, just to full disclosure, I don't know if the man that is your biological dad, if he knew about you at the time.
Yeah, he did.
So he did?
Yeah, because he rang me and I just had a feeling that it was him.
Okay.
After.
Yeah. I feel like, again, when I saw question marks before, I'll say it again. When I see question marks, it's because we don't know what happened.
Yeah.
Or we don't know what transpired.
Yeah.
So I feel like it's important that you know that they're good with you being good with how things are. Do you understand?
Thank you.
Thank you very, very much. Thank you.
Welcome back to Studio 10. Psychic medium John Edward is with us this morning, reading our audience. Take it away, John.
I got to bring up the horse. You have a horse that's passed?
My friend.
What's the big deal that it's a horse? Like, is it
he
like...
He loved it. It was a Clydesdale.
The friend that you said your friend?
Yeah.
Okay, is that friend passed?
Yes.
Oh, so your friend is with the horse. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm trying to figure out why the horse. So that would let you know that it's that friend?
Yes.
Gotcha. And you were the one that asked me the question, correct?
Yes.
Gotcha. So why is October or the 10th of a month significant?
He passed just in October.
Okay. And did the horse pass before him?
Yes.
And where's BR, like Brendan, Brian, Brandon? Who's the BR name? There's got to be, Barbara, there's a BR name that they want me to highlight, either living or past. Remember that I'm saying this. So connected to this, is something BR related in some way? Does he have a sister?
No.
He wants me to acknowledge the other female.
Daughters.
If his daughters would be your age?
Her age.
Who's her?
My daughter.
Oh, hello. So he knows you too? You would know him too?
Yeah.
Okay, so then the contemporaries would be to you. So his kids are your contemporaries?
Yeah.
Okay. Are there like two or three kids for the family or?
Two.
So I'm supposed to talk about, did he view you as being like one of the girls? Like, so like my three girls kind of a thing?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know if there was a brain tumor.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, is that for him?
Yes.
I feel like I'm supposed to acknowledge the brain tumor. But I want to go back when what I said earlier. There's a BR, not as in brain tumor, but a BR as in a person. So there's something about like Brendan or...
But...
Yeah, because it would be Robert and Bob.
Yeah.
If somebody called him Bob. Where's that?
That's my dad.
Husband.
Yeah. Okay, is he still here?
Yeah, best friends.
I feel like I need to... Well, I wasn't going to say that, actually.
Awesome.
I was supposed to...
Brendan.
I was going to say that they were I was gonna talk about them as being like mortal enemies in some weird way. Like, is there a joke?
Yeah, they were always
competitive.
Idiots.
Well, I'm gonna go my way.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna say that what they're showing me is that we're going head to head. So I don't know if the two of them went head to head in being idiots, like who can out-idiot the other one?
Yes.
And they did stupid things?
Yes.
Okay, like, you know, who could do this the fastest, the farthest? Who could do this, who could do that? But I feel like I'm supposed to tease him like he's my adversary.
Yes.
Maybe it's in a positive way, but if you didn't say that, I would have just went like, they're going like this. But like, you know, Superman needs his Lex Luthor. Like, I feel like they've got this kind of a thing. Now, did
Romance.
They... Say it again?
A bromance.
A bromance, okay. Well, did their bromance go for years?
Yes.
Like, did he know him before he knew you?
Yes.
Okay, because I feel like I come first. Like, I came first.
Yes.
And what happened with the roof?
My husband fell through it.
Because he's telling me to talk about the story with the roof. So that might have been one of those things. I don't know.
Yes.
Was he there when that happened? Or?
No.
So this is important. You said he fell through the roof. Did he fall through the roof after he passed?
No.
Okay. Because if they do that, if they show me information about what took place after, then that's their way of basically saying, I see what's taking place.
Yeah.
And I know that the horse is there, but there's a dog here too.
Yes.
I need to acknowledge the dog.
Yeah.
So when they memorialized him, did they memorialize him with a photo of the dog?
I did.
He's thanking.
On his coffin, yeah.
He's acknowledging the photo of the dog.
Yes, it was him and the dog on the beach.
So is his dad passed too?
Yes.
I feel like I'm with dad, but I need to say hello to the older female who's living. So that to me would be his
aunt.
His mom, his aunt, his grandmother.
His aunt.
And then who's playing Mark?
My brother.
They're just telling me to say Mark.
Mark's my brother.
Okay, still here.
Yes.
And then congratulations on the car. I don't know what that means, but...
My husband crashed it. Oh. In 2 months.
He's telling me to tell you congratulations on the car, so their personality is still...
Yes.
And you don't have to let this part air. I just want you to be honest. Was one of the cars, like, not registered? Was there, like, a legality with one of the cars?
Just before Paul passed, he was driving his car and told me it wasn't registered, and I sort of went a bit ballistic at him.
Okay. So the gentleman that passed, not Mark, but not your husband, but Paul. Okay, because he's telling me to talk about the issue with illegal or legality regarding the driving.
Yes.
Okay. And then, hypothetically, might there have been a situation where one person allowed another person to use someone's address because they didn't have a place to send something?
Paul would have done that constantly.
Okay. Well, for whoever did that, he's appreciative because he was able to get something of a financial value, like a check or something in that way. Do you understand?
Yeah, he would have done that constantly.
Now, are you in the process of redoing your front, like the steps, or are you doing a patio, or?
No.
What's happening in front?
The water main blew out the front.
Okay, in front of your house?
Yes.
Yeah. So that's gonna have to be repaired?
It was.
Okay. Again, this is when they show... These are the current
After
events.
Him, yeah.
These are the current events that they talk about. They show me, like, hey, I see what's taking place.
Yeah.
All righty? I hope that this helps you guys. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Wow. Well, let's hypothetically say, like, somebody didn't like their sister's husband and killed him. In that section, who has that? Take the mic back there.
My brother's ex-girlfriend's father killed her mother.
Okay, give me a second. Your, say it again. Your
brother's ex-girlfriend.
Wait, louder.
Brother's ex-girlfriend.
Okay.
Father killed the mother. That made sense. So he killed his wife.
Right. Was she involved with somebody else?
Yeah.
Okay. Because the feeling is I thought it was a different scenario. But that fits my symbol. What were you going to say?
My great uncle shot my great aunt. We're together.
Wait, you guys all came together?
Yeah.
And you guys had the same story. Okay.
Different families.
Different family, but.
So which one's connected to the A name?
A.
Like, is somebody Alex or is somebody Allison or?
Allie.
Who's Allie?
My great aunt.
It's your family then?
Yeah.
So if your great aunt is Allie, then it's that story. And you had the friend that passed before, right?
Yeah.
Now, I would think that that wouldn't be okay in a family if one person killed somebody else's.
I think it was a secret.
Yeah. But I almost feel like, I don't feel like there's a trial. I don't feel like there's a lot of stuff that takes place. It's almost like it happened and we moved on.
Yeah.
Okay. Where did this happen?
Where?
Like, what country?
Here.
Yeah.
Country, New South Wales. On a farm.
It just feels like it happened and we like moved past it. I don't see any type of...
That's what the story's told.
Gotcha. Do you know if part of that story was that there was like she was involved with somebody else or she was doing wrong in some way?
I think he did wrong by her.
And then, which one got killed?
The auntie.
So I got it backwards.
So the lady was married to a brother, and the other brother did something to the lady.
Gotcha. And the lady is the one that was killed?
Yeah.
As a result of what took place?
Yes.
and then it was just move fast?
Yes.
Okay. We're saying the same thing?
Yeah.
I just had different symbols. And did this conversation happen in your family recently? Or, like, did this just come up somewhere?
I think so, yeah.
And is your mom still here?
Yes.
Okay. Does your mom know this story?
Yes.
Is it not her family?
No, my dad's.
Does your mom kind of like to jokingly say this happened on that side of the family?
Probably.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you.
We have a lot of people in our audience this morning who are still hoping to be read by psychic medium John Edward. Let's see what happens next. Over to you, John.
Thank you. Thank you very much. So in this section, where's the janitor, Jeanette?
I'm Jenny.
Jenny, I might be with you because Janet, Jeanette and Jenny are going to come through the same way. Is there a father figure for you that's passed, Jenny?
Yes.
Okay. Biological dad?
Yes, my dad.
Okay. Whenever I use the word biological, I always know that there's another person that we would look at as being like the paternal energy. So if there's a stepdad or a grandfather who kind of has that role, I just need to acknowledge that there's two because I use the word biological. Yeah. So were you hoping to hear about dad today?
Sure, yep.
Okay. Is there any reason why your dad would go like this?
Probably, I don't know, when I was little, like to be good or, you know.
So were you just telling somebody the story about how dad would shush? Or was there something that took place? Or is dad like letting me know like you're concerned that I'm gonna like say something that you don't want me to say on TV? Because I literally feel like...
I don't know, maybe it's related to how he passed. I'm not sure.
Maybe. Well, let's see where he goes. A couple of things. David or Dan, there's a D name that he wants me to highlight. So it's either their way of telling me who they are, please say hello to. So he's acknowledging the D name. Who's the D?
I've got a cousin called David.
Okay. And then does he have a sister?
No.
So who would be his contemporary besides your mom?
Oh, God, I don't know.
Mom and dad still together?
They're both passed.
Okay, so then your mom's coming through because he's talking about the female contemporary
right.
to his side.
Okay.
Now, did you give one of them, like, orders? Like, did you tell them, like...
Tell who? Who?
Them.
Right.
When you were coming here, did you give them, like, orders? Like, they better show up?
Yeah, of course. Always.
Did you do it in the car? And why is the visor down? Like,
I don't know. My sonny's and I always put the visor down.
Well, no, I was thinking more like, do you have their photo in the visor? Or is there something up in the visor they want me to talk about?
Oh, I've got the Mother Mary, like, little card
up in
on
the visor?
My visor, yeah.
Okay, so what they're doing is they're validating the fact that you did indeed give them orders in a bossy pants kind of way.
I was telling these girls I just met today, okay, I hope they come through.
Wait, yeah. Did she really tell you that?
Yeah,
she said that?
There's four of us. Related
to, we were just talking when we were lining up outside, so.
Okay, well, I want you to know that they heard you, and they're referring to you as, like, Miss Bossy Pants, and they're validating that by what you have in the visor. And is that something that was given to you?
Yes.
Because I don't feel like you got that. I feel like somebody hands it to you and you put it there.
Yes.
Okay. Now, was your mom more Catholic than your dad?
They both were very Catholic, both of them.
Okay,
yeah,
so
every Sunday mass.
Your mom's making me feel like you either have her rosary beads or you
yes.
have something that's cross-related to that.
Mm-hmm.
And I say that because I feel like I'm looking at the visor and what's here.
Okay.
But she's telling me to tease you about it, which is a symbol for me. She's making me feel like they only work if you use them. And have you married somebody that's not Catholic?
No, my husband's Catholic.
Okay.
Yeah.
She's telling me to tease you about being in a different faith. So if you married some, they're busting on you. If you married somebody who's Catholic, and technically you're Catholic, and she's calling him a different faith, she's calling you the non-Catholic.
What?
That's how she's showing to me. So do you have a child that's getting ready to make her sacrament, or is there an issue with the sacrament?
My daughter will do her confirmation next year.
They will be there for the sacrament? Can I be personal?
Yeah.
Did you have to say that you maybe went to mass, or did you have to say that you possibly belong to a parish?
My son goes to St. Mary's Cathedral. He's the head chorister there, and I take him every Sunday, and sometimes I go to mass and sometimes I don't. So maybe that's what she's meaning. You're
she's
saying
busting.
You're Catholic, but you're not practicing it every week like we used to.
But to me, this information gives me her personality.
Yes.
And her dynamic with you.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
Now, didn't you just have a conversation with one of your kids about their grandmother?
Yeah.
where you were talking about a story when you were their age, where you were telling something that took place?
Yep.
How personal can I really be?
All right, go. Yeah, that's fine.
Did you technically think you could drive before you actually had a license? And might there have been a circumstance where a car went missing?
Oh, dear. No, not that I remember.
You didn't take the car out to go to McDonald's, or you didn't take the car out to go to a...
No, my dad would get the belt. He'd be ready to, you know.
So, seriously,
old school?
Yeah, where is the story where somebody took the car and they basically took it for a joyride, but nobody knew that they did it?
Oh, dear. I don't know. Maybe I was too young. I'm not sure.
Well, I want to make sure that they're not preparing you for one of your kids doing that.
Oh, dear. Well, yeah, there's a couple of years to go before my son's ready to...
Where's the place where the house had two separate driveways? You did not do this?
No. I was too good as a kid. Like, I was scared to do anything wrong.
Where's the aquarium?
Aquarius.
Aquarius,
the sign. Yeah, yep. My eldest son.
How old?
13.
13. So. I am just going to say, and I'm being serious, I'm just going to tell you that sometimes they will give me information. I always put it as what took place.
Yeah.
I would, this is me being crazy helicopter psychic dad, I would have a conversation with said Aquarius and say, do not get into a car with a friend's older brother unless you know that they're actually, you know, a good driver or have a license. I would then hit it in a different direction, like make sure that you don't do that. Like, I would cover my bases.
Yep.
But I have a thing about kids getting in cars with, like, other kids, and, you know, when your friend's older brother gets his license, like, I won't let my son or my daughter get in a car with a new driver. I don't care how responsible and how great.
Yep.
Not happening. So that's what they're showing me. It has to do with the kid getting into a car. So in my head, I put it to you, being the person who is the kid, but if you swear to me on live television that you did not do this, then I have no choice but to still give you the information and put it to where they showed me the Aquarius. Are those not the shoes you were planning on wearing?
I was going to wear my Adidas, but I thought, no, I better go be dressy.
Because they tell me if we go to your house, your other shoes are out that you were going to wear. Is that true?
Yeah, they were out, but then I decided to put these ones on.
And do you have a palm tree in your backyard?
I've got a monster of a tree. It's not a palm tree, but it's like a eucalyptus tree. It's massive.
Is it like a joke? Like, do you call that tree, like, by name? Or do you, like, call it
curse it. It makes a mess everywhere.
They want me to tease you about your tree.
Okay.
They're teasing you about your tree, and then you know that somebody's having a tooth pulled, right?
Yeah. My daughter did.
Okay.
She already did. She had two taken out a few weeks ago.
They're talking about the tooth being pulled. So I only see one, so that means if there were two, I have to pay attention to one of them. So she must have had a little bit of an issue or an irritation with one of them over the other.
Yes, one was more painful. She was scared. She was crying in the chair when they had to pull it out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because they're only highlighting the one. So if you would have said there were four, I would have said, still, it's just the one that they want me to look at.
Okay.
And then I'm supposed to say that you got a little upset, maybe irrationally upset, over somebody spilling something in your car?
Probably my son, yeah.
There's a chocolate drink that I'm supposed to bring up. Who spilled the chocolate liquid?
Brando, yeah.
Again, just their way of letting you know that they see what's taking place. Guys, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wow.
Fantastic from John Edward. Thank you so much for joining us and for doing that.
Like, I'm here with family.
Do you feel drained after that? How does it feel?
It is. You know what? When I was younger, it wasn't draining. But now that I've been doing this for a few years, it is definitely tiring. Like, I get tired doing it.
Really? It gets more tiring as you get older?
I'm learning as I'm getting
many
older.
Many things do.
You're more mature. Don't say older.
No, I'm older and tired. Oh. It definitely happens. John, not while I'm doing it, but when I'm done.
Yeah. Mm. The thing that amazed me was, I know that there are lots of people that were up above as well. You actually get from everyone. Like, it's not just, you can't just focus on the studio audience, can
Correct.
You?
Correct. Yeah, no, that was like, you witnessed me having like a panic attack energy-wise when I walked out to this beautiful new set and the studio is so big here. And it's like, oh my God, there's people like everywhere, because I know that if somebody's in an earshot, then I can read for them.
Oh.
And then sometimes people don't think that they're allowed to communicate and express that. I've had that happen in venues where people who like worked at the venue, you know, the sound guy or the person that was doing security at the door, I wound up reading for them and they wouldn't say anything because they felt they weren't allowed to. And I'm like, no, speak up.
Can you tell if Sally from accounts is looking at Facebook instead of doing her work?
Yes.
So how does that work then, John? Because when you've got a big group of people in front of you, you can read from any of them.
From anybody.
So if you're doing a like we said earlier, you did a reading for Kim Kardashian. How does that work then? What if you're
same way? I wound up reading.
She's the only.
No, I wound up reading the camera people that were there that day too. It didn't make it into the show, but there were people that like that were there that I wound up getting information about.
Wow. So right now, are you getting? Are you feeling vibes and being pulled, or do you have to be kind of in the moment and switched on to that feeling?
No, I have to be plugged in and switched on. Or if I'm really, really tired, or if I'm sick. Then my energy kind of like I don't kind of block it out as well.
So you have to essentially consciously block it out rather than
which I do really well. Like I am very, very good at keeping because I feel like there's a time and place for it, and it's never appropriate for me to engage with someone if they haven't asked me. It's like so a lot of people will think like when I was doing you know one of my first shows, one of the producers in a car said to me, she goes, she confessed a lot of stuff to me, and I'm like. I am not a priest. So I just figured you knew all this. And I was like, I didn't, but don't worry, I will keep your secret.
It's kind of like Superman choosing not to use his X-ray vision because it would be rude to see people
100%
without their clothes on.
100%. It's not a, you have to have, like again, there's rules and you have to treat this with respect and you have to recognize that. I mean, I could sit in a restaurant and like look across and like read for somebody, but it would be inappropriate. It wouldn't be, it's creepy.
But that's what, again, I think is so amazing with what you do and so special about the sort of person that you are because your life lessons for people, that is what, when I listen to you talk about different sorts of issues, that's what I take away from what you do because we're all looking for that.
I feel like this is my, like, you know, in my 30 years of doing this, like there was a time and place for me just to do readings and I feel like what I'm needed to do now is to teach and empower people to get them to evolve through what the crazy world we're all living in. And if information and readings and answering questions can help do that, then I want to do my job.
Do audiences change the world over?
Well, they're different. There's different cultures, but the issues and the themes are pretty much the same.